So working nights is obviously not an ideal schedule, but there are a lot of ways that I found to make it much more doable and even have some fun with it. So the first and most important tip that I have is to stick to your routines, even if it's at odd times. So right here is when I woke up at 1 p.m., but I'm still doing my normal morning routine as if I was working a regular 9 to 5. So you saw that I just made my bed and then I'm getting my coffee going. And another tip I have is to make the mornings fun and find things to look forward to each morning. I will drink my coffee and watch my favorite show while I'm getting ready and doing my skincare and makeup in the morning. And I also will do little fun skincare things like gua sha massaging and just really making the mornings enjoyable. And I also have found that vitamin D has been such a lifesaver for my mood because obviously you don't see the sun as much. And then I also will take probiotics for gut health because that's just good for you all around. And then I will spend the rest of the morning just doing my hair and makeup.
Are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine. Been trying to get a hold of you all night. We haven't talked in months, but that's alright. Was wondering if you wanted to go for a drive. I just need some fresh air and an old friend.
Hello, so I am currently at work. And it is 1:38 a.m. So I only have about 20 minutes until I'm off. And it is dead slow right now. That's one nice thing about working nights is we get just a little bit less foot traffic. So I'm able to get more of our computer work done and it's just a little bit more relaxing. But I'm waiting for one flight to land. Or I guess it landed actually. I'm looking at FlyPDX and I guess it landed, but I'm just waiting for my last reservation from it. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Okay, so I am in my car and I'm about to drive home. I'm currently in the employee parking lot in our parking garage. And one thing I like to do before I even start driving off, as silly as it sounds, is to take off all my little badges and name tags and everything, because working at the airport, you're obviously gonna have a lot of badges and stuff. And I know it kind of sounds ridiculous, but a lot of times when I get home, I'll have so much stuff to take off and put away that I end up procrastinating it and staying up later than I want to. So one thing I like to do as a little hack is take everything off beforehand and then put it in my bag, so that way my bag is all packed and ready to go for the next day. So anyway, I'm about to start driving, and I also try to make my drive as enjoyable as possible and make it kind of part of my night routine, just because I don't have a ton of free time, and so it's nice to make that feel like part of my time, if that makes sense. So I always listen to a podcast that I like or a good playlist, and I just try to enjoy it because I live in Oregon. The scenery is really pretty too, so I just try to take that all in and make it as fun as possible. Luckily, one bonus about working nights is when you get off at 2 a.m., the streets are dead. So let's go. Thank you. I try to do is to really make my nighttime routine feel like a good chunk of my day. Whenever I first started working nights, I would give myself a couple hours in the morning to get ready and do everything, but I was in like a work mindset, obviously. And then when I would come home, I would be like, it's 3 or 4 in the morning, I need to go to sleep ASAP. And so I just really felt like I wasn't doing anything other than work. And so I was honestly getting a little very down. And two things that helped with that was making my nights, matching the routine of what my nights would be if I was working a normal job. One thing I like to do is either yoga or working out. I don't do this every single night, obviously. I try to listen to my body. Some days I can tell I'm more tired than others, and some days I just kind of want to switch it up. I don't want to keep it too mundane to where that feels like a chore too. But today's Monday, and usually Mondays, or well, today's Thursday, but it's my Monday, and usually Mondays are the days that I have the most motivation because it's the start of the week and I'm rested up from the weekend. So today is a yoga day, and I just got home and got changed into a little workout outfit, and now I'm gonna work out.
Going a long way, hold me one last time. Cushion, OJ, I feel fine. Less on less this time, yeah. One dance won't pass me by, yeah. Cushion, OJ, feel so fine, yeah. Want you hold me one last time, yeah. Less on less this time, yeah. One dance won't pass me by, yeah. Going a long way, hold me one last time. Cushion, OJ, I feel fine.
So I just finished working out and I threw on a sweatshirt, and now I'm going to make dinner. Another tip I have is to try to make your meal times as normal as possible. I remember when I also first started working nights, I wouldn't really eat dinner when I got home because it felt like too late. And so I just kind of wanted to make a more normal eating routine. So when I get up at 1 p.m., I will have my breakfast, and then I'll have a lunch at work during my midway shift, which is usually around like 8 or 9 p.m. And then whenever I get home, I usually do a little workout or just something kind of fun, or sometimes I'll just shower right away and then I make dinner. I'm very excited. I'm making one of my favorite meals. So I'm gonna make some pasta with Alfredo sauce and some broccoli and shrimp. So that is what I'll be cooking. We got a giant chicken in our kitchen. Dinner, and now I'm getting ready to shower. And showering at night after working a long day and coming home from a night shift also tends to feel a bit like a chore sometimes. So a few things I do to make it more enjoyable and honestly something I look forward to. First, I try to make it a separate activity in my mind. I found that having set activities and making the environment different for each one makes my brain feel more like it's like a schedule. Like during the day where the sun is, your brain is like, oh, it's evening or morning or midday. But when you work in the dark the whole time, the hours kind of meld together. So just one thing that I do that's been really nice is I got an Aurora projector that makes the bathroom different colors, and I can just turn off the lights and have that color on. And it's really nice. It feels like a luxurious kind of spa experience situation. So anyway, I am going to show you the Aurora projector, little remote, and then I just turn it on.
Bluetooth mode.
And then you can't see a thing because the lights are on, so 1 second. And then I can change colors. just got out of the shower and now I'm doing my skincare, and I keep my skincare at night really simple. I will double cleanse in the shower, so I'll use like a makeup removing gentle cleanser and then whatever cleanser I need for that day. In the mornings and in the night, I use the Belief True Cream Moisturizing Balm. Not the Aqua Balm, I feel like that one's not moisturizing enough for me, and honestly, since I started using this one, my skin has never been better. Especially in the winter and working in a parking garage outside, like I'm constantly in harsh conditions, and I also feel like the air quality there is not good because obviously we're surrounded by a bunch of airplanes and like fuel exhausts and everything. I do change it up randomly sometimes because I feel like my skin responds the best if it's not getting the exact same thing every single day, but for the most part, this is what I do. And then the only other thing I put on is just like a pump and a half of vitamin E oil. And that's pretty much my skincare routine. I am going to brush my teeth. I may put on a teeth whitening strip, but I feel like the only ones I have left are the hour. We're for 1 hour. Yeah, and I don't really want to be up another hour, so we'll do these for another time. I've been using this Crest 3D White Charcoal toothpaste. I really have no idea if it's any good, but one time a dentist came to rent a car and one of the employees kept asking about toothpaste, and he literally just goes, it doesn't matter, they're all the same. So he could have just been tired, but he's a dentist, so I trust him. There are only a few other things I do before getting into bed, and most of them are to make my life easier getting up. I tend to have a hard time being motivated to actually get up and out of bed in the morning, and I don't know if it's just because my schedule is off or if it's because I work 10 plus hour days and I'm just flat out tired, but I do a few things to make my life easier. The first one is I pick out my outfit the night before, because for whatever reason, that is the one thing getting ready that I dislike the most in the morning, so just having that done. I also unmake my bed in a strategic way, so it's easier to make it whenever I wake up. I just kind of refold the blanket on top of the bed and then just throw the pillows back on, and it's just a lot quicker. And then I also fill up my Stanley cup, so that way my water is all full and ready to go in the morning. And probably my favorite thing that I use that helps me get up in the morning is my Hatch alarm clock. And I currently use blackout curtains in my room because by the time I would wake up, the sun is fully up. And so my room is super dark by the time my alarm would go off. But with the Hatch alarm clock, you can set it. I set mine where it starts 30 minutes before I want to wake up, or just the light gradually comes on. So it kind of naturally wakes your body up like a real sunrise would. And then right at 1 o'clock is when gentle music will come on. It definitely feels gentle and I don't feel jolted the way my phone alarm used to. And the last thing that I do is more of a continual thing, and I think it's mostly because I work at an airport, but I have gotten the flu and COVID since working at the airport, and before that I literally hadn't been sick for 6 years. So I just feel like a combination of working nights, not being in the best air quality, and then also just being really stressed all the time is just not super great for your immune system. So I just try to be as healthy and keep up with my immune system as possible. So I drink Emergency or an Airborne almost every day. And then I also will take probiotics. And then I take vitamin D, like I mentioned before, and also just trying to incorporate as many fruits and vegetables in my diet as I can. But other than that, that's pretty much all I do at night, but technically morning because it is almost 4 a.m. and I'm getting ready to actually fall asleep.
Are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine. Been trying to get a hold of you all night. We haven't talked in months, but that's alright. Was wondering if you wanted to go for a drive.